Find the linear model and correlation coefficient for the given data set. And here we have number of children versus weekly grocery bill. And I think if you have more kids, your groceries will get more expensive. It's just common sense. But here's some data, so we'll take a look and see if the data supports that. Let's get the calculator. And I need to enter some data, so I'm going to quit here, second quit. And then go to stat. And then edit. Here's my L1, it has some old data in it. I'm going to go up and then enter. Oh. I'm going to go up and then hit clear and then enter. That'll clear out all the data for list 1. So now my list 1 is going to be the number of children. List 2 is going to be the grocery bill. So I'll go ahead and enter list 1. And make sure you hit enter after each number. L1 looks good. Now for L2. Now just a casual observation. As I'm entering the numbers, it seems like the numbers increase as the number of kids increase in general. Okay, let me just double check that list. And you can also check and make sure, these are like ordered pairs, make sure that everything is matched up, that your ordered pairs are the same as what's in the table. Okay, everything looks good here, so I'm going to quit. And we want to find the linear model and correlation coefficient. So I'm going to go back to the main screen. I hit second and then quit. Stat, calc. We want to do a linear regression or option 4. And then hit enter. Okay, and here you can see you have y equals ax plus b, and the a actually represents the slope or the rate of change. So you have 20.65 or 20.7 there, and for b you have 119.58 or 119.6. You can use your judgment here as far as the rounding goes. There's no real specification. Okay, so I'm going to say 20.7x plus 119.6. Okay, so there's the linear model. Correlation coefficient, calculator didn't show that. I need to turn on the diagnostic for that. And that's the catalog. So I'm going to hit second and then 0, which is the catalog. Then I have to scroll down to find diagnostic on. I'm going to turn that on. Okay, there it is. Diagnostic on. Enter. And then enter one more time. Calculator says it's done, so it should be good to go. Now let's do that calculation again. Stat. Calc, linear regression, option 4, enter. Okay, now we have a correlation coefficient to go along with the A and the B, or our linear regression. So I'm going to put 0.88. Okay, so there's our linear model and correlation coefficient. So what does that mean? 0.88, that's a pretty strong correlation. Here, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and view this on the calculator so you can see how the data points and the function all fit together. Okay, so I'm going to quit from here, second quit. Then I'm going to go to y equals. I need to get my linear regression equation. That's under a variable, so I'm going to click vars while on the y equals. I'm going to import that function. I'm going to go to statistics, which is number 5. And then right arrow a couple times to get under equation. And regression equation, that's the first one. So I'm going to hit regression equation. And see what it does is it puts that whole long unrounded regression equation in there. So I'm going to hit enter. And while I'm at it, I'm going to turn on my stat plot. So I'm going to go up, enter, turn on the stat plot. And then I hit second y equals or stat plot to change the settings there. I want to have a scatter plot, so I'm going to choose that one. L1, L2 for X and Y, that looks good. Then I'm going to go to Window. Move this over a little. See, look at my data. My first input is 0, my last input is 7. So maybe I'll just put 10 here. And then the first output is 80, the last output is 285. So maybe I'll go for the Y min, I'll put 0. And then for the max, I'll put 300. That way all the values in the table are covered. So your y's are right here, x is here. Okay, so let's take a look and see how this looks. Here's the best fit line, the regression equation. You can see it does fit pretty well. I mean, you have a couple points above and below, but this linear model looks pretty good. So that tells us that our correlation coefficient, suggesting a strong positive, really does fit here. Oh, and if you want to get out of this graph, just go second quit. And under y equals, if you want to turn the stat plot off, you just go up and then you hit enter to make it, and then down so it's not highlighted anymore. And then also if you want to change your window back to normal, what you can do is you can go zoom, and then zoom 6 is the standard window. Okay, well, I hope that's been helpful using the calculator to find a linear model, the correlation coefficient, and also showing you how to display your scatter plot and your regression equation on the calculator so you can process the data.